Feature Friday.
The freshest.
Ross, in case you didn't know, Bala and I love acoustic stuff.
Oh, yeah.
And we love KZ as well.
Yeah, that's right.
So, and this was sent through, so here you go.
There you go.
I heard these 10 seconds of this earlier.
Oh, yeah, girl.
It's so raw, this sound. What the hell?
Yeah, well, why is this sound
so acapella, something?
Equalized, yeah.
Raw, dog.
This is how God gave it.
She's so special.
She's backing vocals, she's lead singer, she's everything.
Hey yo, hey yo, hey yo, hey yo.
Ah, come on.
Hey yo, hey yo, hey yo, hey yo. Shout, shout.
Woo!
Let it all out. These are the things.
That would make an amazing, amazing collaboration with KZ. Pink.
Oh my god, you just called it. Yes.
They both have similar personalities when they perform and stage presence.
My god,
they would make up. They would
sorry.
What the fuck? I literally just saw your ankle spaz.
Yeah, sometimes you know they click.
That's fine. But yeah, I would see them just murder an absolute song or two or three or four or ten.
And Pink is so freaking solid acoustic as well. She's so strong. Oh,
mate. Pink is elite, mate. Like she's
another level.
She's top of the pyramid.
And she really is. But yes, I can see that.
And to me, KZ, every time I watch it, it's just like, yeah, she's there to me anyway. It's like she's top of the pyramid to me, you know? So I always think of, you know, these dream collaborations.
It's like, what would
Titans
happen if,
with Titans. Yeah. Yeah. Like, it would be amazing, dude. Because, you know, Jessie J, she's collaborated with her. Pink would be another one that would be like, Bucky, what?
My God, it would be awesome. I think, yeah, I think you got it.
That's
right.
That's insane, dude. And this is such a... I don't know how many of you are familiar with the sound or, you know, kind of... You know, I'm not saying I'm an expert in sound engineering or anything, far from it. But this is very, very raw.
This is like how it was, how you heard it in the plays without microphones.
This is how stuff goes wrong.
But no, when you have extremely talented people, you know,
I would be afraid if I saw another artist. Sorry to interrupt you. If I saw another artist in this environment, I'd be like, oh, gosh.
You were set up to fail.
Bro, I don't know. Talk to someone.
Yeah, go get
sort
help.
Sort this out.
Yeah.
But because it was KZ, I was like, oh, okay, that's fine. But bloody hell.
The thing is, though, I was going to say, this is the type of environments that even if you're talented, you can go really wrong, but you have to be very comfortable and confident that, you know, that you rely on your guitar player and that guitar player relies on you and you guys are a team. Like, nobody is more than anyone here. Like, right here, you're teammates and you gotta shield each other from any type of mistakes, you know? And I feel like they've got such a great communication. They've worked together before, and she is such a solid performer. She's very comfortable in any type of setting, and you know, she's outstanding. When I heard it at the beginning, I knew she wasn't gonna flop because she's such a solid singer.
Well, she's proved it in other very harsh environments.
Yeah.
My,
I guess this is perhaps one of the hard
that we've seen her.
Yeah.
I guess maybe we shouldn't be. Maybe this should be the expectations, you know, that we should have of all singers. It's just that right now, there's so many what I call, and we've discussed it, so many studio singers and not live performers. KZ is first a live performer and then a studio singer.
That's right.
Which is the right order, you know? Learn to actually know your instrument in the harshest of situations, which is a cappella with
so
in a room with terrible equalization.
Yeah.
You know, because then this moment, the moments where you're meant to break, you shine on, and that absolutely makes the difference. It makes you an anomaly in the industry. It makes you a formidable force to reckon with. Maybe this should be the expectation as fans or as music listeners, and then as creators or something else, but as music, people should have. Like, you should shine in the harshest of environments because you should be a live performer first and then a singer. It's just right now the industry is in such a bizarre position, and we keep noticing it that the more we delve into different industries, that it's a universal, not issue, but it's a universal tendency that's happening. First studio, then live. And you get performers and artists that have never been on stage
before until, you know, one of the songs blow up. And like, what they don't know how to handle it. Like, how can you throw? It's like throwing somebody in the sea who doesn't know how to swim without floaties, you know? It's like, try, paddle. Go ahead.
But they look amazing in a swimming pool, in a controlled environment.
Yeah.
But then when you drop them in open seawater,
that's
a completely different animal.
It is.
And they drown.
Yeah, that's right.
Or they're learning as they. Bro, it's, I don't know. Difficult. That's why I really appreciate it. All of these singers we've watched from the Philippines. Their first live performance, and then studios.
And it all comes from karaoke, baby.
It all comes from rehearsals, birthday parties. It all comes from weddings. It all comes from then live performance. It all comes then from gigging and touring locally.
Yeah, that's right.
Start small, but you gotta get out there and get used to being out there and get used to not this sound.
Yeah.
But I guess... I
the real life sound, yeah.
You know, the sound out there. This isn't real.
That's so true. I totally agree with you. It's like going outside without makeup. Get used to that.
Get used to your beauty first. The beauty of your voice, the beauty of your sound, the beauty of your face.
That's right. So freaking cool. Things I can do without camera. I'm talking to you. Come on. Oh, it's ridiculous. Shout.
Clip on.
Yeah. I'm gonna pop some tags. Only got 20 gallons in my pocket. I'm a hundred looking for a comma. This is freaking awesome. I'm gonna pop some tags. Only got 20 gallons in my pocket.
It's got like that Rosario, isn't it?
Yeah, I can. Is it?
I'm.
Oh my god, girl.
It's not, but
it's not, but it kind of looks like it. Yeah, that was ridiculous. That was just ridiculous. That was so good.
It's insane. She's
so
comfy
too.
How can
people be like that, you know? Like, yeah, there we go. That's what it is.
Like, that's my performance. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Thank you. Like, glad you liked it.
Have this wad of cash.
Now I'm gonna take your money. Goodbye.
Oh, well done. I mean, let us know what else you'd like us to watch. One thing that I've wanted to watch more of is, you know, there's so many singers in the Philippines, but I'd love to have like an acoustic, buffet.
Little special.
No. So yeah, I mean, it could be a podcast, it's absolutely. Like, but if you have any acoustic performances and stuff like that, do send them through because I love them.
Yes.